Hi, I'm Andrew with Baker's Gas, and we're here today with an all-new Lincoln Electric 215 MPI. So, 215 amp machine, MPI stands for multiprocess inverter technology. Just came out, newest machine on the market today. We've had it all week, we've been welding with it, got some customer testimonial with it. In this video, we're gonna go over the new features on this unit, the new style on this unit, we're gonna weld with it, and then we're gonna go over the packages that you can get this unit in. So, just to jump right in and start out, first thing that I noticed when I got this unit was, look at the new package. So if you recall, the older unit, 210 MP, didn't have two handles here. Then they made it a little bit more robust, and it's, I guess, you know, if something were to fall or tip, it's got better protection. 46 pounds this unit weighs. Got a new screen, and it's pretty nice. We'll flip the unit on here in just a minute. It's got, if we want to flip around on the back, got two gas ports. It's got a built-in solenoid for the TIG welding, and then obviously the solenoid for your MIG welding. And we'll flip this over, I'll open up the door. And one of the new things that they just added to this unit, obviously we got our old, all our specs that we want to come through. If we want to choose our wire, gas, that sort of thing, gives you parameters to select from. Kind of gives you a breakdown on what all the buttons are on the front of the machine if you're not familiar with them, but it's very similar to the old machine. But one of the new things that we, see is the drive rolls. If you notice, it's all kind of enclosed and very nice. So this kind of mimics the industrial grain machines that Lincoln makes. So we got a tensioner there, flip that up. And then this is the wire guide. And these on thread here. We'll go over this here in just a minute, but I just wanted to show you guys that, I mean, they really built this thing to last. I mean, it's very nice. So that's a cast aluminum piece, and that helps guide the wire between the drive rolls. So very nice. On their industrial units, that comes in handy, because if we're running a lot of wire through there, I mean, it's easy to feed it in, and it actually keeps it everything in a nice straight line. Shut that down. Well, then we'll power this thing up. So let me power it up here, and then we'll go through some of the features on the front of the screen. So power button's on the bottom, right below the big knob there. Flip it on. We got it running on 220. So one thing, this is the MIG Ready Pack. So it comes with a MIG gun, all your adapters, your regulator, spool of wire, ready to MIG weld. So if we go down here, we got our home button. So in the screen, just like the 210 MP, but a little bit bigger, a little bit nicer screen. The MIG steel C25, so 70 by 25. We got our 100% CO2 function, our manual CV, which is if we don't want to use any of the ready set weld features, we can just go right to manual CV or MIG welding. We got flux cord wire that's self-shielded. There's a spool gun package that you can get with this, so for the aluminum spool gun, stick welding, TIG welding, just like I said earlier, it's got a built-in solenoid, so TIG torch will plug right in, gas will flow through the machine through your TIG torch, and there's a TIG ready pack as well. Settings manual, and then new on this unit, it has a memory feature. So if you really like one of your settings and say you're welding on thin gauge material, you can go into that and we can save it in one of four slots there. And all you gotta do is just hold down on a button, but I'll show you that when we go back to the thing. So we're gonna go back home. We're gonna go back up to MIG here. We're gonna click on that. It's gonna show us our setup, how we're supposed to have them connected. We got them connected. Hit okay. Gas connection, yep. Then we're gonna choose our wire size. We're just gonna go 035. And then we choose our metal thickness. So this unit on 220 goes up to 5/16 thickness on the steel. We're just gonna click on that. So it gives us a recommended parameter. And obviously between the green is where we wanna be, and outside of that, where we don't want to be. Now, one of the features on this, and I'm going to go back home real quick, we're going to go down the settings. It has Arc FX on it, which is also new to this machine. So we go to the FX, Arc FX, click on it. We want to enable it or disable it. Now, for those of you that don't know what that is, we're going to enable it. We're going to go back home. We're going to go back to this, toggle through. Now, the Arc FX is going to give us bead profile. So when we adjust our wire feed speed, that adjusts our penetration profile. So as I adjust that, it's going to show on the screen, as I go down, the penetration profile decreases. As I increase my wire feed, the bead profile increases heavily. So you notice that, that goes all the way up. So we're gonna go back into the green. And then if I go over to voltage, this controls the concavity and convexity of the bead profile itself. So if you notice, if I go down on voltage, the bead gets more ropey looking. Now if I increase voltage, it becomes more concave. Is that, and that's pretty neat. That's a new feature of this unit. It's called Arc FX. Now you can disable that so you don't have that feature show up, but pretty neat to have it on there. I mean, it just gives you instant gratification on what you want to see your bead do. So while you increase wire feed or increase voltage, pretty nice. It's on the heavier duty equipment like the Lincoln 360 MP. So they added it to this new 215 MPI. Pretty awesome little feature. So going back home, what we're gonna give this thing a shot, try is we're gonna stick weld with it. We're gonna select stick. We got our polarity set up right. We're in the positive polarity on our stick electrode holder, and then we got our ground in the negative polarity. Gas connection, no gas connection required. Click on that. We're gonna run 7018, 3/32. Got that. And I got some thick material. We're just gonna turn it all the way up, 3/16. Now to turn your output on, you gotta use this knob. What happens is you go boom, boom. So that's, if that's not green, it will not weld. But when you turn it on, it puts power. So it's open, circuit voltage opened up to the stick electrode holder, but we're gonna shut it off right now. And what I wanted to do was show you how to set up the memory. So say I got a stick electrode, I like 105 amps. Here's our FA. I'm gonna click for options. We're gonna go to memory. So we got that first one. We're going to press and hold the save. So when I come back to stick, I don't have to jog through all that and forget what I, you know, try and remember. I can just go right to memory and our home screen. And go memory one. It gives me right back to my stick welding. Turn our output on. We're at 105 amps. Now, I'm not going to weld at 105. We're just going to try out the 100 amps, what they recommended. But I just wanted to give you a quick rundown on how that memory feature worked. So let's give this a shot here. So we got our 100 amps. We got Lincoln Excalibur 7018 here, 3/32. Nice running rod. Let's see how this machine goes. Smooth arc, really smooth arc on that. At 100 amps, that ran really good. Look at that, the slag's peeling right back for us there. Looks pretty good. Check that on. Yeah, real smooth arc. I mean, look at that beam. That's real nice. That's pretty impressive. I mean, it fired right up and it didn't stutter at all. We're 100 amps, it seemed to run just fine. No fluctuation. Now, regardless, we're on 220 volt though, so we're running at the highest output. So just on the highest output, you get 215 amps. That's a 30% duty cycle at 215 amps. And you can do 20 to 230 amps right on the 220 output. But on the 110 output, you can do 20 to 140 amps. So you're not limited too bad. You can still do 140 amps on the 110 setting. And that thing welded great. That's pretty nice. So let's break back down and I'll go over some of the packs and features that this you can get with this machine. So after welding with this machine all week, and we did some customer tutorials on it, we stick welded and MIG welded with it, and the customers really liked it. They liked the Arc FX feature, and they liked the Ready Set Weld feature. But for garage home hobbyists, I mean, that's perfect for you guys out there, because it gives you the bead profile, and it gives you like a good parameter to start with. And then if you're an experienced or advanced person and you don't like all that, just you can go straight to CV mode, and you can adjust your wire feed and your voltage independently of one another. So it's got a feature for everybody out there. Great home hobby, light fab kind of machine here. But they come with three packages. The first one's a MIG package. In the MIG package, it comes with everything ready to MIG weld, ground clamp. Comes with the Magnum Pro 175L nozzles, contact tips, one spool of wire, a little spool of wire. The drive rolls are already in there. So it comes ready to set up for that, and that's the first package. Second package is the spool gun package, and that's going to come ready to weld aluminum with the spool gun, and it's going to come with the spool gun and everything that came in this ready, the MIG welding package in the beginning. And then the third package is the TIG ready package. That comes with everything to TIG weld. So that's going to come with a corded foot pedal, TIG torch, TIG consumable kit, and everything ready to TIG weld, plus what the original MIG package comes with. So this machine's going to compare price-wise to everything on the market that's in this ballpark. We're going to link everything below, and all the different packages below. And if you got any questions, comments, anything, if I didn't answer any of your questions, please leave them below. We'll do our best to answer them. Thanks again for watching. Subscribe to our channel. There's more stuff coming. It's all good stuff, so stay tuned for more. Thanks.